When you're first getting into digital radio, you often won't understand the technology's details or how it even works. This confusion can create an uncertain feeling of whether digital radio is even the right way to go. Hi, I'm Tanner with Bridgecom Systems, and today I'd like to discuss how digital technology has created a new form of radio communication, DMR. Specifically, we'll discuss what exactly DMR is, the key terms you need to know, and specific radios we offer in the world of DMR. Firstly, let's get a general understanding of what DMR is. DMR stands for Digital Mobile Radio. DMR was created by the European Telecommunication Standards Institute, also known as ETSI, to create an open standard. This open standard goal was to make a digital radio system that was inexpensive and simple to operate while allowing different radio manufacturers to develop interoperable radios. This interoperability enables users like you and me to connect without being limited to one single system. Another goal of this digital standard is to improve or replace analog. DMR has done this by improving voice quality, functionality, security, and channel efficiency. DMR's improved channel efficiency is a result of its two-slot TDMA functionality. TDMA stands for Time Division Multiple Access. TDMA provides two logical channels on the 12.5 kHz channel, meaning that as opposed to the older analog communication, you have two slots for communication instead of just one. Essentially, you have the power of two repeaters. DMR has many moving parts with essential functions that contribute to your radio working, but there are a few that are vitally important to using DMR. Firstly, before you even get your radio, you should have your DMR ID. A radio ID is a unique identification number assigned to you and your call sign. Your ID works just like any other digital ID number, such as your phone number. Your radio ID identifies you as a unique radio user on DMR networks like Brandmeister and repeater systems. We've made a video on how you can get your very own DMR ID. That link is in the description down below. It will show you all the steps to follow so you can get your ID without getting lost. Another fundamental component of DMR is color codes. They're very similar to the continuous tone-coded squelch system tones being used in analog. Color codes in DMR are just like CTCSS in that you need to get the appropriate color codes from the individual or club running the system to open the repeater. Without the proper code, you won't be able to use the repeater. To gain access to the repeater, you will need the repeater's frequency, color code, and time slot. Now, what is a time slot? If you remember earlier when we were talking about TDMA, we referenced how it was a two-slot functionality. This is the time slot. Time slots are two dividing signals within the fixed frequency that allow more than one user at a time to use the same frequency. All DMR repeaters are equipped with this ability. Repeater owners will typically program different talk groups between the slots to make the most of their system. Talk groups, to put it simply, are a way of organizing radio traffic on your network. You can manage your talk group in many different ways, including countries, states, regions, or even cities. If you want to personalize your talk group, you can even organize it by unique interests from hunting to technology. You can create these talk groups via a code plug. A code plug is the software file that gets loaded into your radio, telling it what to do and how to operate. Basically, anything you can do in your radio. Building your code plug all by yourself can be an intimidating task, but it doesn't have to be. To overcome this fear, we created a super code plug. Our USA and International Hotspot Super Code Plug contains statewide talk groups for all 50 states in Washington, D.C., countrywide talk groups for all 78 international countries available on the Brandmeister network, and receive-only channels for all 7 NOAA weather frequencies. So if you want to get around doing your own programming, you can upgrade to our Super Code Plug. The link is in the description. All of these intricate pieces of information work together for you to communicate on a network. A typical DMR network like Brandmeister consists of node controllers and several sites. To make it easier to digest, here's a graphic to break it down more simply. Networks like Brandmeister allow DMR repeaters to connect worldwide via the internet and link systems together by utilizing organized talk groups. Knowing what DMR is and how it functions, what kind of radio systems have been developed to help hams make use of this breakthrough technology? Well, let me share with you some examples. Here at Bridgecom Systems, we offer a wide array of radio equipment, including repeaters, handhelds, mobiles, and if you don't have a repeater in your area, even hotspots. Rather than offer your substandard gear, we selectively choose the best quality DMR equipment. We provide tutorials, guides, and courses so you can quickly understand the fundamental parts of your radio. This is all done with you in mind so you can easily make your first DMR QSO. If you don't have time for all that programming, order our most popular product, a plug and play package. All we need is your DMR ID and call sign, and we'll program a radio and hotspot perfect for you. Click the link in the description to order the most popular item in DMR, the Plug and Play Package. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed learning about the revolutionary technology of DMR and how it's helping hams connect across the world. Thanks again for watching, and 7-3.